Good morning. I'm Lynda Cromar, coming to you from my home office. And I just want to address one thing. I'm not going to make this long, but just recently, Donald Trump started using one particular phrase, and he's actually talking to the minorities of our country who have typically voted in the Democrats all the way up and down the ticket. And he said, what do you have to lose by trying something new by voting for Trump? And I actually want to expand that. What do you have to lose as an American who has enjoyed the freedom that we have in this country to give it a new chance, a new person that has never been a politician in the past, Donald Trump? Now let's review for a moment some of his attributes that makes him a good candidate for our president this year. For one thing, we know that he has been extremely successful in his businesses that he has done. A lot of people will try to point out some of the things he failed at, but anybody that has ever been in business before, in any way, shape, or form, knows that you don't win all the time in business. You do have failures, and you do have debt, and you do have things that don't work out the way you think they are going to work out. But if you look at the overall track record that he has a huge business. He has many concerns, and all of which is usually on the winning side. He has done many different things, not just one thing. Now we know him as a builder, but we also know him as a book writer, an author who has been on the New York bestseller list and has been on all of the Amazon's bestseller lists. That is a big accomplishment. He has been involved with all sorts of businesses. He has bought businesses that failed before, and he has turned them around. Now, there's some attributes. Now, think about those being used as our president, someone that can truly turn things around that were failing before. Don't we want that for our president? So, what do you have to lose? Now, there's a lot of apathy in our country right now, especially because it seems like both sides are rigged. It seems like both sides are just another part of the same fixed system, the same rigged system that we've been suffering with for a lot of years. That would be true if we were talking about any other candidate but Donald Trump. In fact, this is something you probably don't know, and that is that he actually won the primary and they tried to give it to Ted Cruz. They failed, but they tried to give it to Ted Cruz. And I don't know whether you were aware of this or not, but even in the Republican National Convention, there was a contingent of individuals that were trying to railroad enough of the voters over to Ted Cruz that they would actually be able to undermine his supporters and take away the nomination. They did not succeed to do that. One thing that Donald Trump has done consistently through this whole process is that he fights the establishment. And he doesn't let them get away with the crap they've pulled in the past. That is another reason why I support Donald Trump. He is not bought, he is not controlled by any of the entities, such as the special interests and the big unions and the big corporations that have in the past been controlling both sides of the ticket. So now we have somebody that is truly outside of this rigged system. Now, one of the other things I want to point out to you that I want you to just think about if you're still one of those sitting on the fence, is that he has done a lot of things that he promised he would do. Why not give him a chance? Because if you look at his real record, not what the news media wants you to see, but his real record, he always does what he says he's going to do. For instance, here's just one small example. He had been watching the city fail miserably with this skating rink that was in City Park. They spent billions, not millions, but billions of dollars, and they wasted it on a system inside that rink that just could not work. And so he finally said, I've had enough of seeing this mess. I'm going to take over that project. I'm not even looking for profit, and I'm going to get it done under schedule and under budget. Guess what? He did exactly as he said he was going to do. That is now a skating rink that functions as of today. And that was 7 years of failure on the part of the city government in New York City. If you just look at that one little example, then you would see that his track record is consistently that he does exactly what he says he's going to do. Now, a lot of people get real upset about what he says. Sometimes he lets his mouth get away with him. And sometimes he gets a little rough, and sometimes he does a little bit of name calling. But I want to point out to you that his opponent not only says things that are stupid, she lies consistently, and her lies cause people to die. There is no time in any of Donald Trump's history that has happened in his businesses. And you would think, with as many businesses as he has, he would have some record of that. So that is another good thing to think about. Another thing is he's accused of being a bigot, which is absolutely ridiculous, because if you look at his employees all over the country, not just in New York City, he has the largest amount of minority and particularly women who he has promoted to very prominent positions in his organizations all over the country. That tells me that he really judges people by their record, by their heart, by their willingness to work, and by their industry. Why not have that kind of president? What do you really have to lose? I encourage you actually to really go in there and study the man, not just go by what the news says, but study the man deeply, intently, from every source that you can possibly find. The news is not going to tell you the full truth about what he is really about. You know, I didn't know a lot about Trump before, but I have read his books, and I do know that he puts his name on high quality wherever he goes. Why not make our country, for once, high quality like it once was? Because it used to be that when you had a label on something, made in the USA, that meant it was the highest quality possible of that product. And that is what we want for our whole country. We want to put people back to work. We don't want to be at a place where we could actually be so dependent that we can never, ever recover again. And there is one final word I'd like to give you. And that is that this president, whoever ends up being elected, and I dearly hope it is going to be Donald Trump, is because we are now going to see many of our Supreme Court justices get too old to continue in their job. They're either going to die or retire because of age-related problems. That means that the president is going to be the one that actually puts in new Supreme Justices, could be up to five in the highest court of the land. We already know that when it is a left-leaning judge, it is going to be somebody that thinks that they are supposed to make laws. And the Supreme Justice is not supposed to make real laws. He is supposed to interpret the law that has already been made by our Congress and signed by our president. We need to preserve those three branches of our government, in both our national government and in our states. If we allow it to continue, we will no longer have representative government at all. And they're trying very hard to take that away right now with all of the garbage they're pulling. They're doing their best to try to eliminate voter registration for the purpose of allowing people that don't have citizenship to vote. We need to stop that. We need to stop it now. We need to return back to the U.S. values, the Christian values that did make this country great. I hope this helps you. I hope you'll share it. And I hope you'll give it very high consideration, because this is going to be one of the most important votes that we have ever had to do for many, many, many years. Because in the past, it didn't appear that either one of the candidates really had much to say. But you only have to listen to one of his talks recently in the last 2 weeks to know where he truly stands and where he wants to take our country. He wants to bring us back to the values that made this country great. And it's going to benefit absolutely every individual, not just the black community or not just the Mexican community, but all of our Americans, regardless of their skin color. And that doesn't even matter anymore to me. What matters is, let's vote in such amazing numbers that they can't possibly try to snow us and make it that she won, when we know full well that you can't even find that many Hillary supporters anymore. Most of them are not supporting her. Democrats are moving in record numbers into our pool for the purpose of electing Trump as our president. Let's do that. Let's all turn out in huge numbers. Let's share the important things that need to be shared. Let's not get our heads turned by things that absolutely don't matter. And let's stay focused on bringing Trump and his Vice President Mike Pence into the presidency so that we can turn our country around. Share this, please, so that everybody that you know, in particular, anybody sitting on the fence at the moment, I am inviting you to share it all over the place. And I hope you have a most awesome day. I'll be talking to you again soon. Bye for now.